The budget department is asking for a 4.5 trillion peso national budget for next year. In the top 10 list of agencies that will get the biggest chunks of funding, the Department of Health ranks 5th. The Education Department tops the list, followed by the DPWH, DILG, and the Defense Department. With this, senators asked, why does it seem like the government isn't allocating as much as they have expected for the DOH, given the fact that it is the leading agency in the fight against ongoing pandemic?
Why it is that health is only 5th in the allocations for 2021. Tinitipid po ba natin ang ating health sector sa tulong at suporta?
In the proposed fiscal year 2021 budget, it is true that the government aims to boost the health sector to address the COVID-19 pandemic. However, may we also emphasize that we cannot rely on the budget of the DOH alone in order to reduce the impact of COVID-19. On the social and economic well-being of the country. Thus, we have also provided budgetary support for other agencies like DSWD, DOLE.
Initial budget allocation for the DOH this year was at 104 billion pesos, but due to the pandemic, its funds were increased to 153 billion pesos. However, for 2021, the DBM only allocated a proposed budget of 131 billion pesos for the health department.
I question, Mr. Chairman, the reduction of the DOH budget from the present 153 billion, as adjusted versus 131 billion, which is in the present in the 2021 budget. As pointed out by Senator Villar, we need to improve our testing, we need to improve our contact tracing, and we need to improve our ability to treat. But how can we achieve these policies when you have reduced the DOH budget?
Budget Secretary Wendell Avisado explained that they already poured in a huge amount to the DOH this year so they could buy testing machines. And they expect that what will be left for expenditures next year are the testing kits and PPEs for healthcare workers. Senator Cynthia Villar meanwhile complained about the DOH not using their funds to build COVID-19 laboratories. Villar said only 30 out of 70 DOH-operated hospitals have COVID-19 labs, when in fact all these hospitals should each have one laboratory.
They have the budget, but they don't want to build.
Yeah.
Because during our DOH operated hospital, they did not build. We built that COVID lab. I built that COVID lab. They did not build it because they don't want to build it. So I want a commitment that they will build. Kasi pwedeng naandun ng pera pero ayaw nila gawin.
Yes.
You ask Senator Gatchalian. They don't have any COVID lab in Valenzuela. And he told me that he asked DOH to build. And sabi daw ng DOH, mag-donate ka. Diba, Senator Gatchalian, you told me that.
Senator Risa Ontiveros meanwhile expressed worries about the funding for vaccines, which was pegged by DBM at 2.5 billion pesos. Avisado said the amount is good for 3.8 million poor families. But based on the calculation of Senator Ontiveros, the government would need at least 189 billion pesos to provide vaccines for 18 million poor families. Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez said that Health Secretary Duque only asked for a 20 billion peso fund to procure vaccines, and he thinks they can find a source for this. But Senator Ontiveros insists 189 billion pesos should be the minimum budget for vaccine, and it seems like Secretary Duque is underestimating the budgetary need for vaccination. Meanwhile, Senator Franklin Rilon took notice of the 16 billion fund allocated by the DBM for the National Task Force to end local communist armed conflict. While other agencies like DOLE only gets 15.9 billion and the Department of Tourism will only receive 3.5 billion pesos. Rilon questioned whether communist insurgency will be a bigger threat next year compared to unemployment rate and shutdown of tourism industry. Avisado explained that the allocation will not go directly to the task force but will be downloaded to the LGUs. He explained that the budget will be used for barangays cleared of insurgency so they can start their lives over with livelihood programs and all their other needs so they won't be tempted to go back to insurgency. Reporting for News 5, Mea Ann Los Baños, we are One News.